So, welcome to the session, guys. It's about matching process and relevance of IR in OJT. Okay. So the expectations from this session, actually, this session might have heard the stuff that I say already with the previous sessions that I said, but I wanted to take you all through the matching process, what exactly happens in matching. So y'all might already know the things that I'm going to say. So I want y'all to engage as much as possible, not only listening to me when I'll be asking questions in between a lot. So please feel free to answer. If y'all know the answer or if y'all think this is the answer, just open the mic and say the answer. Okay. So this is not only for team leaders, team members, y'all also please engage as much as possible. And also please pay attention and as usual ask questions. Okay. Now, do you remember the session that I did earlier? Customer flow. Okay. So I did a session called customer flow. So can anyone remember the customer flow or the funnel? Anyone who can remember the order of the customer flow? Or at least the first stage. What is the first stage? Someone can answer.
Sign-ups.
Okay, sign up. Then?
Applied.
Applied. Someone else can answer. Pumi, what's the next stage?
Accepted.
Accepted. And then?
Approved.
Approved. Okay, so Lakmi, can you remember what's after that?
No.
Okay, fine. Imelka?
Don't know.
Okay, so after approval, it's good that you all remember till approval. So after approval, it's realization. That is the EP goes to the country and then he finishes and then completes. Okay, so this is the customer flow. But today we need, in the customer flow, we need from sign up to approval. That's the matching in the matching process. We need from the sign up stage to the approval stage. So I'm going to take you all through the matching process and what you guys as members should do in this process. Okay. So first stage is sign up. So can someone tell me what is sign up? Like if the EP does something and we call that as sign up. So what is that thing that the EP should do to mark that should do in order to be the sign up in the sign up stage? Can someone tell? Devni?
No idea.
Okay. Buddhi? How does we get a sign up? It's the question is, how does we get a sign up?
No idea.
Okay, no idea. Theogene?
He informs someone from the ISAC that he is interested in applying for an opportunity.
Okay. Okay. Imalka, what do you think? Is the answer correct?
Yeah.
Okay. So basically signing up is when a person creates an account in ISAC.org, that's when we get the sign up. Okay, I remember telling this in the customer flow session as well. So signing up. So in Expa, if you see, I don't know why, but I can't load. In Expa, you can see we get, these are the signups that we get. Okay, when you go to the people, we get all these signups. Okay, so how we get these signups? If we consider what Theogene said, if they say as interested, like verbally, if they just tell that they are interested, we don't have anything to know that they are interested. No, so they should sign up. in isec.org, they should create an account. Then in Expa, we'll be getting their details. Okay, that's what we call as signing up. Okay, just the same meaning, signing up in the website isec.org. Okay, so that's the meaning of sign up. Okay, so how do we get a sign up is, if the in when creating the account, if they put University of Colombo as their institute or one of the external entities which comes under ours as their institute. Here I can show you all. Here I can show the their institutes here. Wait. Okay. So something went wrong. So the thing is, if they when they sign up, if they select University of Colombo as their institute or an institute that comes under Colombo Central, for example, RI, okay, Royal Institute, if they put something like that as their institute, we'll be getting the signups in expa.org. Okay, we'll be getting their names. Okay, that is the meaning of sign up. So they should go and create an account in isec.org. Okay. So that, hope you all are clear with this. Okay. So the next one is, after we get the sign up, we should cold call. Okay. We should cold call or contact through WhatsApp, that EP. Okay. So what will happen after signing up is, basically for the VD team, your team leader will give you the signups, will assign you the signups that we get. Okay. After she assigns you the signups, you have to contact them. You have to contact them through your WhatsApp or by like you call that person and contact. So when you're contact, first thing is you have to introduce yourself that you're from ISEC, you're from you're a member and so on and so on. You have to introduce yourself, and then you have to of course talk about GT. So that is pitching basically. So when you talk about GT, you have to say about the opportunities that we have, and you have to tell about the cost that the EP has to. And don't ever hide anything from the EP. Like when the cost means, you have to tell about the tell that the EP has to pay the ticket fee, pay visa, and they have to pay the admin fee and all of that. Okay, so all these things you should tell the EP openly. You should be very transparent with the EP. Okay, and you have to also mention about salary. So this is when someone goes to a GT opportunity, work internship, they'll definitely be getting a salary. So you should tell that they'll be getting a salary as well. That's so you should make a balance between the cost and the benefits that the EP will get through the way you talk about GT with the EP. Okay, so after you, they already know, actually when they sign up in the website, they already know somewhat about the opportunity. They know that they are going to apply for work, okay, and in abroad. Okay, so they know somewhat, but they don't know that this is from ISEC, and they don't know what is ISEC, they don't know what is GT and all of that. So you should make it very simple and clearly explain everything to the EP. Okay, and then what you have to do is, you have to get to know about the EP's requirements. Like some people want to go to European countries, some people want to work in Asian countries, some people doesn't have the money to spend so much and go to Europe. So some, like that, there are certain requirements that the each EP will, that will be different from each EP. Okay, so you should make sure that you get the requirements. That is also you should ask about his profile, that is, what is his degree, whether he is a fresh graduate or a person who has work experience and all of that. Okay, you should ask about all of that from the EP, and what kind of work he is looking for. Okay, some people will be having a business degree, but they'll be looking for marketing opportunities. Like that, people have different requirements. Okay, so you should all you should ask about the EP's requirements and all of that, and then you have to get his CV. Okay, so get the CV from the EP, and then looking at his CV and his requirements, you have to send him suitable opportunities. Okay, so this is the basic thing. Okay, so you have to send them suitable opportunities. So this should be done when you contact that EP. Okay. And then this is one main thing. This is mainly for the VD team. When your team leader assigns you contacts, and you contact that person, and some people will be replying to you, some people will be completely ignoring your message, and all of that thing happens. Okay, so always you have to update the tracker. Okay, so the tracker is where me and the TL will be checking on each of the EP. So you should always, after contacting the EP, update the tracker. So when I talk about the tracker, this is the tracker that we maintain between me and Theogeny, your VDT here. So here you can see that we have the names of the EPs, we have their contact numbers, the member who is assigned, and the updates. Some people have applied, some people didn't respond, some people have responded, like that. And the field of study, and whether we got their CVs or whether we sent him opportunities. Like this, your TL will also give you a tracker. This, the tracker that I showed you, me and Theogeny will be updating, but she will send you a particular tracker for your team, the VD team. So you guys have to update it. She'll be explaining you about that more, because this session is more for the entire membership in OGT, not for VD team particularly. So I'm not going to focus on that more. So for the VD team, never forget to update your trackers, okay? And then this is one question that I wanted to ask you. If you have a personal contact who is interested, what will you do first? Okay, so here I told you, when we get a sign up, we get it through Expa. We don't know anything about that person. I get the sign up. I don't know who that person is. Some people can be from, not even from University of Colombo. Okay, so I don't know all of them. Okay, so we just meet that person when you're contact, when y'all call or what contact through WhatsApp, y'all meet that person freshly. You can't ask about that person from me, because I also don't know. Okay, so these are signups we get through the website. Okay, but now maybe your brother or sister is looking for a work. Okay, maybe one of your friends is looking to go for an internship. So if you have a personal contact like that who is interested, what will you do first? Can someone tell me what you'll do first? Anyone? Imalka?
Introducing about the Isaac, first of all.
Okay.
And make him to make an account in Expo.
Exactly. Okay, so that is the first thing that you need to do. Okay, so this person, maybe like when you do so much of ISAC, your sister or brother will be knowing about that. Okay, they'll know what you are doing. Okay, so what is the first thing that you need to make that person is make him or her create an account in ISAC.org. So Expa is used by ISACers. So like when you said the answer, you said create an account in Expa. It's not Expa. Expa is what we use. So for the outsiders, you have to make them create an account in isec.org. That is the very first thing you have to do. So that when you make that person create an account in isec.org, we'll immediately get that sign up on Expa. Okay. So when we get that sign up on Expa, we can easily contact that person, have the details of that person. Okay. And also, you know, the number of opens, number of signups also counts when we compare all the entities, the performance of all the entities, the number of signups we get also counts. Okay, so you have an interested person, and if you're not making that person sign up, then it's not gonna count. Okay, so always make him or her create an account in isec.org. And always ask them to put University of Colombo as their institute, okay? So your brother or sister might be from University of Moratuwa, but when they create an account, always mention them to create an account mentioning University of Colombo as their institute, because then only we'll be getting the sign up under us. Otherwise, it'll go to Columbus, or that is the second University of Moratuwa, okay? So always mention, ask them to put University of Colombo as their institute, okay? And then, okay, now relevance of IR, okay? So can someone tell me what is IR? IR is a common word, not only in ISEC. IR is a common word used everywhere else. So I'll ask from one of the members, Devni, what is IR?
International relations.
Exactly. Okay, international relations. Okay, so in ISEC also we have international relations. Obviously, we definitely need to have international relations. Okay, so IR is really, really important because when EPs apply to opportunities, if they apply to opportunities from an IR partner, so IR partners is that is basically. In Sri Lanka, you know, there are 8 entities like that. In other countries in the world, there is ISEC and there are so many different entities. Okay, so we can talk with an entity which does good IGT, like OGT and IGT should be matched. You guys know when we send a person abroad, that is, we are sending through OGT, our function is working, and the person who accepts it, the entity which accepts it, is doing IGT from their side. Okay, so when we have good IR partnership, means the OGT in our country and an IGT in a different country, a local committee will have a we'll have a meeting and we'll have groups, and when we form an IR partnership, what happens is they tend to accept the EPs from our entity. Okay, so they'll be getting hundreds of applications. Okay, but when they get an application from our entity, they'll try to accept that person soon. Okay, so the percentage of sending an EP is more when we send when we make our EP to apply for opportunities from our IR partner. Okay, so do you guys have any doubts on what I said now about IR and IR partners? So I assume there's okay, no doubts. Okay. So when you consider IR, we have IR partners. So nationally means ISEC in Sri Lanka, we have partnerships with India, Turkey, Malaysia, Australia, and Egypt. Okay, these are the 5 countries that are partnered with us. So when you make the EP apply to an opportunity from these 5 countries, they tend to accept our EP more. Okay, an EP from Sri Lanka, they tend to accept us more, but we can't surely say they'll definitely accept, because it depends on the CV and the qualifications of EP as well, because they are going to take him to a work and they're going to pay him salary. So we can't say 100% this is going to happen, they're going to accept our EP, but we can when we compare, like when the EP applies to a random opportunity, UAE, they are just applying to UAE or US. Most of the people want to go to countries like US, Canada, so they'll tend to apply to countries like that. So the chance of getting them selected is very, very less when you just make that person apply to a random opportunity. Okay, but when we make that person apply to an IR partner, an opportunity from our IR partner, they tend to accept that person more. Okay, so these are the 5 other national partners that we have: India, Turkey, Malaysia, Australia, and Egypt. And LC wise also, we can have partnerships. So as LC, these are the partnerships from this year. So from India, we are partnered with Pune and Jalandhar, and from Turkey, we have partnered with Izmir and Sakarya. Okay, so these are the names of entities, like Columbus Central is a local committee, no? So these are also local committees. This is like the countries, okay? ISEC in India, ISEC in Turkey as a whole, our country, ISEC in Sri Lanka, is partnered with them. As an LC Columbus Central, we are partnered with these local committees, okay? So these are some of our local committee partners that we formed this year, okay? So when you consider about this, I want to take you all to tracker. So you all might be wondering, okay, so as I told you, you need to make our EPs apply to opportunities from these entities, these countries. So you might be wondering how to search from these particular entities. Okay, so when you go to isec.org, we have like hundreds of opportunities, and it's very random. Okay, you can't go and search for these countries' opportunities, and when you go to search for opportunities, you will be searching under the EPS preference, like for marketing, and also you want to search in India. So it's hard to find in ISEC.org. For that only, we have something called IR trackers. I'll take you all through the IR trackers we have with our national partners. This is an IR tracker of Malaysia. So can you all see that? I hope you can see the IR tracker. Okay, so here you can see there, this is a Google sheet, and you can see I'm in the tab IGT opportunities. Okay, when you look at this tab, this sheet, here you can see the opportunities, okay, and the sub product. So you have an EP who wants to apply for marketing. So you can see there is a marketing opportunity here and here, here, and marketing also, it differs, the titles differ, okay. And the LC's name, it's under Malaysian, so the local committee's names are also here, okay. And here you can see the opportunity ID. So you want to see what this opportunity is all about, okay. So here they have the opportunity links, okay. When the EP wants to apply, they want to have the link to the opportunity, otherwise they can't apply, okay. So these details are not only enough, you need to have the opportunity link. So that's in this column, okay. Here you can see the salary that they are going to get. This is in ringgits, the Malaysian rupees, and then you have the duration of the internship and all of that. So some opportunities prefer countries as well. Here you can see this opportunity, the country preferences Hong Kong, Taiwan, Korean, those countries, okay. And because they need the language, okay, say they need Mandarin and so on, so on, okay, languages like that. Here you can see requirements of the TN. The requirements of the TN means the company which provides the opportunity needs these requirements from the EPs, okay. See, look at this opportunity. They need an EP who has the experience in cold calling and sales, preferably has experience in managing full sales cycle, native Mandarin speaker and writer as well. Like that, each of the opportunities, see these opportunities, they don't have any requirements like that. So we don't need to worry about that. But some opportunities have requirements, okay. So like that, we have to look at, when you have this tracker, you can easily see whether the EP that you are talking with has the has the right requirements and worth CV in order to apply, okay. So I'll share you guys these trackers after the call ends today. Your TLs will share you the trackers. So when you look into these trackers, these trackers are only for you guys, not for the EP. So when you go to these trackers, you should always sign up with your ISEC account. And other accounts won't work, so always sign up with your ISEC account, the account that you all created in ISEC with the ISEC.net, that format. Here you can see I'm using my ISEC account, okay. So like that, you have to use your ISEC account to access these trackers. And this is for y'all, again I'm saying this is for y'all to access, because some members tend to send these trackers to the EP. That's of no use, they can't access the trackers, and also it will be very difficult for them to process this trackers, okay. So it's for y'all, you guys have to go and see whether an opportunity will work for that particular EP. And what you need to send to the EP is this opportunity link. Here, this link, when you look into this, just click on this link, okay. When you click on this link, you'll be getting the ISEC.org link, opportunity page, okay. So you can send this link here, you can see this link, just copy paste and send it to your EP, okay. So here, this is very easy for the EP to process. It has the details, the role description, the salary. When you sign up, they'll get the fee details that they have to pay to ISEC and all of that. See, skills they need and the country and everything is here. So the EP, see, the computer, whether they provide computer accommodation, all of those details that the EP requires is here. So if you send this link to the EP, it's very easy for them to process that, okay. So they can easily apply. See, if they put apply now, they can go into the process of applying to the opportunity. Okay, so what you need to do is go and search in this tracker. So first thing, when you have an EP who is interested in going, don't search in isec.org. It's very hard. So first of all, go through all the trackers, and still if you can't find any opportunities for the EP, then go and search in isec.org. Okay, so this is the tracker of ISEC in Malaysia. I'll show you other trackers as well. This is one of ISEC, this is ISEC in Australia. So Australia has not that many opportunities. So you can see these are the few opportunities that Australia has now. Okay. Developing data scientists like that, they have a variety of opportunities. This is ISEC in Egypt one. Okay, so they have some of the opportunities in Malaysia. What you all saw was they have just put as IGT opportunities as a whole, okay, in one tracker. But in this tracker, you can see they have separated it as teaching, okay. When you have an EP who wants to go for teaching, then you can immediately go and search here, and the opportunity links are here. You can easily send that, okay. And marketing opportunities, business administration, business development, engineering, IT, and all of that. Okay, so we have all our national partners trackers with us. So I'll share you guys the trackers. So go through that. And when an EP wants to apply for an opportunity, first search thoroughly through IR partners, because when we make the EP apply to an IR opportunity, it's more beneficial to us. Okay. Okay. Now, do you guys have any doubts in this IR part? Any doubts? Okay. I assume that is a no. Okay. Okay. Now, after IR. Okay, now you have sent an opportunity. So find opportunities from IR partners. When you find opportunities, don't just send one opportunity to the EP, but also don't send like 10 opportunities and make the EP confused on what to choose. Just send, you already have the requirements. You're not going to send random opportunities. You're going to search opportunities based on their requirements. So always search on the requirements and from the IR partner. So send maximum of 3 opportunities to the EP. Not more than that, not less than that, okay? Send 3 opportunities so that the EP can clearly have an idea and apply to these 3 opportunities easily, okay? And always make sure they apply and follow up, okay? Don't just relax that, okay, I have sent the opportunity, they will look after this now. Don't be like that. Make sure they apply and follow up on that, okay? And also, this is very important, check when you get the EP CV, when they're going to apply, always check on their CV, okay? So the thing is, when I talk about CV, I'll show you one example for the CV that we have. Example for the CV. I'm not going to show the person's name, but look at this. This is a CV of 5 pages, okay? This person has worked, he has done almost 5 or 6 jobs, okay? But his CV looks like this, okay? If you are an employer, will you be looking at a CV of 5 pages? Will you be interested in a CV of 5 pages? No, right? It's like no one will be interested in looking at a CV of 5 pages. Okay, if they have details of 5 pages, that's fine. But these details are not at all worthy for an opportunity. See, they have put the things that they have done in each of the work, okay? That's not at all required, okay? And they don't have the person, it's not something very pretty or neat, okay? It's neat, but still this has too many details that the employer doesn't need, okay, require, okay? So always make sure, because the employer is taking someone from Sri Lanka and paying really huge salary to that person, okay? So they will be needing a worthy CV, okay? So even though this person have 5 different job experiences, this person will never get selected because of the way his CV looks, okay? So that's why when you contact that EP and when you're making that person apply, make sure to check on that CV. And if you feel that CV is not word, not proper, always create or modify the CV. You can create the CV newly. You can ask from the EP to do that. Say that I told you, I showed you the requirements that each opportunity needs in the IFSHRKA. So based on that, you can ask the EP to create a new CV. But if they don't know how to do it, you guys can create the CV. Creating CV is not that of a difficult task. When you go to Canva, you have the template and all of that. So you can, or you can ask help from your team leader or the marketing members in OJT. You can ask help from them. So create or modify the CV according to the requirements of the opportunity, okay, that the EP is applying. Okay, so that is one important thing, an issue that we have right now. Okay, so after applied, okay, let's say this person has applied to an opportunity. Now the accepted stage. Okay, so when you consider the accepted stage, that is the EP should face the interview and get selected. Okay, this is exactly like a job interview that a normal person would go and face, in except here the EP has to face it virtually, like online. Okay, so you have to make sure that the EP faces an interview. Okay, that don't happen often. So what you have to do is, once an EP applies to an opportunity, you have to immediately contact the host entity. Can someone tell me what's a host entity? Lakmi, do you know what's a host entity? Hello?
No.
Okay, no. Nuan?
No, no idea.
Okay. Pumi?
The ISEC entity that the EP applied.
Exactly. Okay. So we are the home entity. That is, the EP belongs to us, no? So we are the home entity. And when we send an EP abroad, the people who are going to host that EP, the word itself has the meaning. Okay, the entity which is going to host that EP, give the work opportunity, that's the host entity. Okay, so most of the time when the EP applies, the host entity doesn't contact that person. Okay, so you should make sure that's the benefit of IR partners. When we have IR partners, it's easy to get their contacts, get the contact of the vice president or the managers in that, or TLs in the entity. So it's very easy to get their contact. So you have to contact that host entity and schedule an interview, okay, for that EP. So sometimes the EP will get a mail automatically. The host entity will be sending a mail, but most of the time it doesn't happen. So you should make sure to contact the host entity and schedule an interview for the EP. So when we contact the host entity, most of them will ask you all to create a WhatsApp group with the EP, you, the member, and the host entity. Okay, so you guys have to create a group with all the EP, adding the EP. You guys will be there, the member who, the EP manager, basically the EP manager will be there, and your TL and the host entity. All these four parties should be there in the WhatsApp group. Okay, so when you are in the WhatsApp group, it's easy to communicate the host entity. Just keep in your mind that the host entity is not someone who takes the interview and accepts it. Okay, they just provides you the opportunity. They have a company, they are partnered with a company, and that company, through that company, we get the opportunity. Okay, the host entity is someone who facilitates that. Okay, so the actual relationship is going to be between the EP and the company. Okay, the home entity, that is Colombo Central, and host entity are the, like a bridge in between EP and the company. Okay, so the company has to finally accept that EP. Okay, take the interview, and if they're satisfied, they'll recruit him. Okay, so they have to recruit that person. So the host entity is actually going to help us. Okay, so the host entity and home entity will work together to make sure that the EP gets recruited by the company. Okay, so they also will help us and try to make that EP gets accepted. For that, we need to have a good communication. So WhatsApp group is really important. So they'll tell us these are the requirements that the that the company needs, this is how they should face an interview and what time the interview will be, the day, and all of that will be communicated through that WhatsApp group. Okay, so through this WhatsApp group, arrange an interview. That's all what we can do from our side. Okay, after that, the EP has to face the interview and the company has to recruit him. That's all. So our part is to arrange for the interview and make that EP get prepared for the interview. Okay, so and then now let's say the EP get accepted for the opportunity. Okay, so now what we need to do is get them approved. So accepted is the most difficult part, because you guys know that we still didn't get an acceptance. So getting accepted, that is the company saying yes to our EP, is a really hard part, because they are going to pay a huge amount and they are going to recruit someone outside their country. They can do this just by, they can do the same job just by recruiting a person from their country, but they are willing to give the opportunity to an outsider. So they'll be looking at, they want to have the right qualification and they'll select the best person. So getting the accepted part is the most difficult thing. So after getting the accepted, it's very easy to get the approval, because here what needs to be done is the EP should sign the contract. So, okay, so I'll show you the contract that we have. Okay, so this is one, this is a contract. So you can see this session also was done in the legal procedures. Hope you all remember this. We showed the contract and all of that, but I'm again showing you. So this is a contract which will be signed by me and the EP and EP's parents, and finally by the National Director of ISAC. Okay, like that, it's a very 63-page contract. So the EP has to read everything and sign on it. Okay, so when they sign, and then they have to pay the admin fee. When these both are done, we can make we can mark the EP as approved. Okay. So can someone tell me the admin fee? Can someone tell me what's the admin fee that the EP has to pay for GT opportunity? Someone who know?
If it's within 6 months, it's $180, and if it's more, it's $220.
Okay, great. So glad that you'll remember. So exactly what Pumi said, 180 for less than 6 months opportunities, more than 6 months, it's $220. Okay, US dollars. So you should have told this thing when you contact the EP in the first place, like when you called a call and all of that, you have to say this admin fee. So now you should make sure that the EP pays this. So this is done, this is an online payment that the EP does. So when this is done, the EP gets approved. Okay, so this is an opportunity, this is not a GV opportunity, this is a GT opportunity where the EP is going for a work, an internship. Okay, so the EP will be looking forward to get accepted. So when they get accepted, we can easily make that person approved soon. Okay, so as soon as possible, when the EP gets accepted, make sure to follow up and make sure that the EP signs a contract and pay the admin fee. So when they sign the contract, actually when the EP applies to an opportunity, they'll automatically get the contract through their email. But if that doesn't happen now, like due to some system errors, that won't happen. So when they didn't get the contract, what you have to do is immediately contact your team leader. Okay, so team leader and I will make sure that the EP gets their contract, and they have to sign it and send. Just when they sign it, it will automatically, all the others will sign and it will get uploaded. And then they have to pay the admin fee through their account, ISAC account in YOP, ISAC.org. They have an account, so they'll pay it through online, the admin fee. Okay, so when this is done, the EP gets approved. Okay, so this, now the EP is matched. Okay, so I wanted to take you all through the matching process and what things that you need to do. So that's all from me. So now the EP is matched. So we got an approval. Okay, so getting an approval in OGT is not at all an easy task. We from our term started, we are in the third month right now, February, March and April. Still, we didn't get any acceptance and approvals. Okay, so it's not at all an easy task. We should work hard and follow up on the EP, and have good IR partners, and make sure that the EP applies to an IR partner, and make sure that the EP has good CVs to get them approved. Okay, so when you get an approval, it is huge, because last year we got five approvals, only five approvals, but we got an award at APC. Okay, so getting five, so that is a huge thing. Okay, getting five approvals itself is not at all an easy task. So that's why we got an award. Okay, so make sure that you all do all the things that I said now, and make the EP matched. Okay, so you guys have any questions on this whole process? Any questions that you all got?
Hello?
Yeah, let me.
You said the person should first sign up. And when should that person sign up?
Okay, so normally what happens is, when we do promotions, like it can be physical promotions or online promotions, when we put our product into public, they see the links and sign up. Okay, when we do promotions, they'll sign up. We can make them sign up on, like, when we do the promotions, we can have a make them sign up immediately then and there. Or when we post ads on Facebook and all of that, they can go to the link and sign up. Okay, so that's the sign ups that we normally get. Okay, but if you have a personal contact, you can make that person, ask that person to sign up through the website. Did I answer your question?
So if a person likes to go in the next year, is that okay if we sign up in this year?
Yeah, that's fine. That's completely fine. But the thing is, when that person signs up, you have to immediately contact that person. Because if we don't contact that person, we'll definitely forget about that person. Like next year, I won't be there. The same team won't be there. Okay, so that person will be forgotten. Okay? So what you have to do is contact that person immediately. We don't know if the person wants to go this year or next year. If that's not a personal contact, we don't know whether that person wants to go this year or next year if we don't contact that person. So make sure to contact that person. And what I will advise is, try to make that person apply this year. But if that doesn't work out, you have the tracker, right? Tracker of it. So in that tracker, mark that this person wants to go next year. Okay, so mark that person. So so we can contact that person at the end of this year. Like if they want to go next year, we should at least make that person apply by the end of this year. Okay, at least in November or November at least, so that we can do all these procedures. Okay, so for that we have to mark that person and remember that person. Basically, you have to remember, keep that person in your mind, that this someone like this